Welcome to HortTube. My name is Jim Putnam. In this video, I'm going to be talking about ferns. There's a beautiful house full of ferns here. I'm at Bracy Nursery in southern Louisiana. This is a beautiful container nursery. You can see some drone footage while I'm talking here. They sell primarily to independent garden centers and landscapers. It's a wholesale nursery, and it's a really, really well-kept, really, really nice place. And they grow a lot of encore azaleas. They grow a lot of the southern living plant collection things that you see me talk about. But I was passing by this house of beautiful, beautiful ferns here, and I wanted to talk about them because I've never talked about ferns at all. And many of you have shade spaces. Many of you have deer problems, and some of these are deer resistant. They've got some holly ferns, some autumn ferns, some Japanese painted ferns, and some southern shielded fern. And let's go through them one at a time. I'll start with this southern shield fern right here. This is actually a native to the southeast United States, native to Florida, over to Louisiana. It's hardy in zone 7 to 10. It's a really, really beautiful fern. It can get kind of longer fronds than some. This one can end up, you know, 2 feet in height or even a little bit more than that. It's very deer resistant. Of course, it's for shade or park shade. They can take some direct sun in the afternoon, but they can't stay in it very long. So, you know, dappled in and out of full sun is okay, but it's definitely a shade loving plant, and they would prefer, you know, in moist conditions, but not necessarily a total bog, but they wouldn't mind a, you know, moist condition. And you can add some compost when you plant these, would definitely be helpful. Southern shield fern is deciduous, but frequently the foliage will last right up into early December in the south, and you just leave that foliage there over the winter, and then it puts out beautiful new growth. The fresh new growth in the spring is really beautiful. The next one here, these are holly ferns in this group right here, so named because it looks, you know, has a holly looking leaf on it. Of course, it's, you know, very, very soft to the touch actually, but this one's actually an evergreen fern. It's hardy in zone 6 to 10, so it's slightly more hardy than the shield fern. Up in zone 6 and probably 7A, it's slightly deciduous. It won't be fully evergreen in those areas, but this has always been one of my absolute favorites. I mean, how can you beat that color in a shaded space? And while I'm down here in late March, of course, spring has sprung in the deep south, and so it's just covered in this new lighter green foliage, which matures to a dark green over time, and also deer resistant. Next up here is the Japanese painted fern, and this one starts out kind of a light green color, and then the center of the leaves mature into a silver color. It's really beautiful, very striking, stays a little smaller than the holly ferns and the shield ferns. It may only reach, you know, 12 inches in height, maybe 12, 18 inches in width. All of these spread underground by rhizome, but very slowly. Also deer resistant, but this one's really beautiful. And in a dark shaded space, it really stands out, where sometimes the darker green ones can get a little bit lost when they don't have this, when they have the new growth on them, they're all super, super showy. But this one will stay showy in the shade, and up against one of these other ferns really pops. This one's a hardy in zone 4 to 8. Japanese painted fern is also herbaceous. It will die to the ground in the winter time, and so is autumn fern. But autumn fern starts out in the spring with this beautiful copper coloration, and then it turns a darker green. And there's a period of time every year where these are just so stunningly beautiful in the spring and right into early summer. And then again in the fall, they'll take on some of this coppery color. They eventually will die back to the ground, but typically not until about December in my area. So there's only a brief period of time that they're not up. And these are hardy in zones 4 to 9. So very, very hardy fern, a wide range that you can grow autumn ferns in. But you can see, you know, there's autumn fern, holly fern, Japanese painted fern, and then the southern shielded fern right there. All of these, certainly one of them, would look great in a garden. They're all deer resistant. They're all pretty tough plants. And like I say, they can all take some direct sun. You don't have to give them absolute shade. But, you know, I would say that they wouldn't want more than about an hour straight of any kind of midday sun. So I have one more variety right here. This is a lady in red fern. I didn't see these at first. They have a beautiful crop of these. And this one gets red stems right here. It's the most cold hardy of the ones I'm showing you. It's hardy in zones 2 to 8 and get a little bit bigger than the other ones. This one can reach, you know, as much as 3 feet in height and about 3 feet in width. Again, it's going to be deer resistant, and it's herbaceous. It's going to die to the ground in the winter time. This one would just look fantastic with a low growing hosta or a heuchera, and all of them would. You know, if you get some sort of contrasting lighter foliaged hosta or heuchera, of course hosta, if you're trying to be deer resistant, hosta wouldn't fit that bill, but the heuchera and the heucherellas would. So all of these are going to want moist, well-drained conditions. So if you think the space, sometimes shaded spaces can be just flat out wet. And if you think that's the case, go ahead and mound them up when you plant them and don't cover anything that's on them. Ferns don't require a lot of fertilizer, but they can be a single application of a slow release fertilizer in the spring would work great on them, and we probably would end up producing some additional new foliage on them every year. And that's about it. They're extremely low maintenance, and it's just kind of nice to have something in a shade garden that you know, you don't not having to worry about the deer. And if you know that you can mix and blend these ferns together, these hardy ferns together, and really get a lot of color out of them. You know, green is a color. Some people, you know, only want, you know, when they're thinking of color, they're only thinking of flowers, or they're purple or whatever. But some of these greens and these coppery colors on these ferns, you know, really do stand out in a dark shaded space. So thank you to Bracy Nursery for letting me take over this greenhouse for a few minutes. And thanks also to everybody who's watching. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for future videos.